I'm only humbled that he could give his life. It's not a small thing that I will leave. He gave it for me. The champion.
Keep it at home.
Apostle Moses Enrandio, by the grace of God, is a man I've known for a long time. I can tell you that man is an apostle more than any apostle you may ever know. He's stepping in here from 20th to 22nd is to give someone a direction to life. Invites people, prepare for it, and get ready for it. Amen. Well, thank you. Let me sit down. Genesis chapter 12, if you have your Bible. We're looking forward to close at a good time. If I preach it, I'm closing here. If I teach it, I'll take more time. Which one do you want?
Teach it.
Preach it, teach it. Oh my goodness. How many of you have been blessed from the beginning of this month?
Yes, sir.
How many of you, you can see something turning around in your stomach?
Yes, sir.
Throughout the week, we were coming here apart from on Tuesday, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
We were coming here. We were here on Tuesday, that's true. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Why has it been here even on Tuesday? Thank you, why have we been here on Tuesday? Give me Genesis chapter 12, 4, verse 1. How many of us were here in the first service and you were so blessed? Let me hear you say amen.
Amen.
Listen, I want to encourage all of you. I think about two services. It's never the same. It's never, even if I preach the same thing, even if I read from the same scripture, you will be blessed. Don't be rushing home to do. We are looking for a change of life. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not hearing the name this time. Is it that you won't tell us? It's like I'm just talking to the choir. Oh, Chama, you came to church, you went on your first service. You missed. Serious. Let's stand and one more time just to read this scripture and then we'll take it from there. Somebody will receive favor this week. Please, when you receive it, call my number.
Yes, sir.
And let the word shout into the world that the Lord is good. I'm serious.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I just heard the Holy Ghost say, someone, you will see something you are looking for. There's something you're looking for. You will see it. It will shock you how you will find it. You just find it. All right. Let's read as a family. King James Version. Any other version, close it. After that, you can open it. Have you found Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 in your Bible?
Yes,
not on projector, meaning the Bible. If you have, can we read one to go?
Now the Lord has said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto the land that I will show thee.
Go ahead, verse 2.
I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and make thy name great, and thou shalt be
Verse 3.
And I will bless him that bless thee, and curse him that curses thee, and in thee shall all the nations of the earth be blessed.
Amen. Thank you. That's all. Thank you. Verse 4 says, so he departed. Amen. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's read it. Let's know that he didn't just stop there. Read verse 4. As what happened?
As the Lord has spoken unto him, and Lot went with him, and Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran.
See that? Our Father, bless your word, one more time. Your word is blessed. Then make it blessing in our hearts and our lives. Let it transform our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Agatha, come. Don't worry, I'm not feeling you. Come. I'm loving you. Come. Come this way. Get high chair. Can this carry on? Or sit down. Bring another chair. Put it here. Sweetheart, come. Because you look at me that way, that's why I say come. Sit. I'm going to speak on what I call greatness amidst uncertainty. Greatness amidst uncertainty. Put verse 2 on the screen while I break it with these people. Now look at these people. Look at Agatha. She's in the spirit. For whatever may Papa call me out, Lord save me. Don't worry, I'll come, God will save you. Are you looking at her?
Yes,
and I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
If I will make of this lady as big as she is. I like this hair, let me back it up. By the time I'm done making of her, will she remain the same?
No, sir.
Something would have left her. And that thing that will leave her, I will make it to become great nation. It's not like as big as she is. And they're not having the same color. I have advanced her, but she is not the same. So for me to make of her, there are certain things that must be possible. Her compliance to me. Her what?
Compliance.
She must trust me and comply. She must offer herself, number two. Until she offer herself, the things I'm going to do to make of her will be painful, so she will revolt against it. So the process of making of her, of this thing that will be great, and that will make her look back and say, in retrospect, thank God. God touched me. Will not make her smile at the beginning.
Yes.
They bring pain. They bring disappointment. She need to trust me that even in her pains, that I'm making of her something great. Is somebody here? The question this morning is, how many of us are willing vessels in the hand of the master to make of us great nation. It's not as though the promise of God is not real. The willingness of the one to whom he had promised to offer himself. Listen to me, church. The Bible says there was a discussion in heaven and Jesus agreed to come down on earth. But when he saw the pain, when he saw the agony that would take him through the roof, he went to his father and said, "Daddy, that thing we discussed, not according to my will, but your will. But if you want me, sir, if you ask my opinion, let this thing that will make me great depart from me." Then the father looked at him and said, "Oh, son, I wouldn't let it depart from you, for that's the only route that that name given among men. And at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, of things in heaven, of things on earth. It is only when you allow me to make of you that which I've spoken." The Bible said that Jesus prayed and prayed and prayed and fasted and prayed so that the making of him will be taken away from him. How many times have we prayed in our prayers that our answers, not knowing, should be taken off from us? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
No, I'm not sure. You want God to promote you, wave your hand. Huh?
Yes, sir.
You want God to make you great, wave your hand. But do you know there are some prayer points you have prayed that has stopped that greatness? Jesus prayed. But he was careful to say, "No, at this time, my mind not the same." Sir, he offered himself and said, "Not my will. I am ready to go through the pain if you insist, but if you ask me, take it away. Take away the disappointment. Take away this. I don't like the way I'm going." And then we also have prayed in a prayer, "Lord, overturn and overturn and overturn and overturn again until it comes by right." And the Lord began to overturn by disappointing you, disappointing you, disappointing you, and disappointing you. And you don't even know he was stunning. If he had answered you from number one, he has not overturned.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, somebody hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So that God said, "I am overturning it, overturning it." Every man that comes by your life has their role.
Yes, sir.
They may not be the assignment, but they have a role to prepare you for the real man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But if you don't have understanding, you will die thinking, "I'm an unbroken." Meanwhile, the Lord was making of you. Then maybe you may appreciate today, for I know the thoughts I have. So if you allow this one to come, it's part of his thoughts. So he is making of me. This person has a great character. The character is not good. It will get on my nerves. But there's a part of me that God wanted to strengthen. And he needed a man of great character to come into my life and teach me that sometimes life should be like this sometimes. We should learn to endure and manage it.
Yes, sir.
And then when you thought the person should, what we thought must happen, that the person should learn and repent so that we can move on. God said, "No, no, no. He doesn't have what the real man is going to have. He doesn't have this man. This man is good, but he will not teach you this kind of life. Because in this life, if you will be great, you will meet all kinds of people." You didn't hear what I said? You will meet all kinds of people. Life will bring you before many kind of characters. So God begin to unroll, unroll, unroll. Somebody came and disappointed you. Somebody promised you and failed. God said, begin to learn that he that put his hand on the plow and look back at nothing. Then also he that trusted the man is a fool to learn it, that you trust men discreetly and not absolutely.
Yes, sir.
You shouldn't trust man at all. Out of that is making of you. Then we don't understand that he is working it out. Because our eyes is on the result. I call it result-oriented generation. The generation of quick fix. The microwave generation. The generation that does not endure process. Look at as the Lord was making of her. What the Lord did after was better. Because whatever the Lord doeth, he doeth his what? So by the grace of what the Lord has done in her life, she also become a better herself. There is a way life will treat you. And certain times you now ask yourself, I say, am I this person? Am I still this person? Because I'm not sure. This is not how I would have handled issues. Wait a minute. Life has turned you around, processing you by the reason you are getting better. You are getting better by the day, because there are certain things you encounter according to the will of God for you that some other persons does not encounter. And that's why, please, don't run your mouth when you see people go through certain things. You don't understand them. Do you understand? Don't run your mouth when you see people go through trouble. Say, hey, see that? You don't even know where God is. We generated them too. I will make of thee. Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless you. I will. So, they once they will be made of, must be ready to offer themselves. Are you available in the hand of God? Are you available for God to use you? In our generation, lack of understanding who God and the way he operates has made some people lose opportunities. You want everything that happened in your life to be explained. Excuse you. Life cannot be explained all the time. Did you hear what I said? There come a time in your life when not even you can explain why certain things are happening in your life. You make the best preparation. You organize yourself somehow. The bubble will burst. You say, but I resist this makeup and I prepare for it. How come? Hey, he's making of you. Very long, that song is very easy to sing, but are you ready to do that? Offering yourself, is it brethren? Therefore, offer yourself as first a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. He said, this is your first reasonable service. The first service that is reasonable is that you give yourself. I give myself away. Thank you. not that, you don't come to church. Some of you are so funny even. If they ask you, ask somebody this week, church, and they say, never, they didn't bring lights. So I didn't iron my dress. Hello? And you sing that song. I gave myself up. Things you don't need. You know what I mean to give yourself away? When nothing counts when it comes to you and God. When it becomes God, you don't need that count. The roadmap, the pathway to greatness is first sacrifice. The first pathway to greatness, if he that must be great, the Bible says, let him be what? A servant. Don't mind these ones that grow wings over certain opportunities. They never see greatness. And I can tell you that they don't go too far. Once your wing begin to come, when God has not allowed it to come, situations of life will break it. Let me ask this question because I don't have much time again. Are you ready to make of you a great nation? Are you ready for God to make of you greatness? Now I understand where God was coming. And then he come, they never knew. There was no child 75 years. And God has promised. He didn't know it would take another 25 years for him to give him. That the process of God making him took God 25 years to get a child. And when the child has grown to 12 years, there's bonding. God came back again. Part of making of him, he said, give me what I gave you. Not with a spare. The spare would have been, God first made sure that Ishmael had gone. They couldn't dress Ishmael. There was no other. As far as Abraham is concerned, Ishmael is gone. So God began to place a demand on him when there was nothing he has as a plan B. Excuse me. No wonder God said to him, if I will make of you, leave everything. Do you see that in verse 1? He said, leave your parents and relatives. Took one. He said, this one is so dead to me. Let me help you. He took Lot. You saw how Lot ended.
Yes, sir.
Did you see how Lot ended?
Yes, sir.
God took him. In making of him was a sacrifice that I gave him. What was God trying to make of him by asking him to sacrifice dependability? God will bring you to a point in your life that he will be sure that you can depend on him. He will take away everything from you. Take away, listen, can I tell you something? Church, it is so strange. Let me explain this to you. If you like that money and say you want to start church, God will not show you something until that money finish. I've been living with this. I need money. And so when the Lord called me to come to my, I said, what is it? What do I need? I'm comfortable. Young man in my 20s. And I said, what do you think? Money day. I said I will not take offering. So that people don't think I need their money. It is arrogance, meanness, pride. Did you get what I said? I didn't want anybody to say, because I've heard and said, pastors come to collect offering. And then, so after church, and God gave me people of means. After church, they will be online. Offering will be 200 naira, but they will spend like 2,000 naira. Not the surrender is included. Just those I gave. I said, thank you for coming to hear me preach. I counted it a privilege that I even see people who sat and I was preaching. So after serving, by my pastor, transport, even those their houses by this, I give them. There was one day I went to visit one of them. Lo and behold, she was using a Nilo container as a pot to cook beans. I cried and went to the market.
buy beans, buy pots. This is my member, cooking. Oh my goodness, but there were my members, and any day I don't see her, the vacancy, because she come with 3 children or 4 children. So that space, the 4 covers, is a lot for me. Until the money finish. I begin to depend on God. I begin to pray for, give us this day our daily bread. I began to learn to trust him on a daily basis, and I do not have made mouth, therefore I will not go and tell anybody I beg you today. He set me up, preparing me for a time like this. Are you ready for God to make of you a great person? God asked him, say, Abraham, give me that thing on which I promise your greatness. And Abraham didn't go to talk to Sarah, because Sarah, most of this conversation that God had with Abraham, Sarah was not in the picture. How many of you know that? All the most of the time, Sarah wasn't there. So you will be so callous of him to go and talk to somebody who doesn't understand the dealings of God over time. Like now God is helping you, teaching you certain things. And now the person you want to go and talk to over certain things is somebody who has not heard the kind of word you have heard. You know what he will tell you? He won't understand why you're stupid. He won't understand why a dedicated woman like you will be every day, you just wait and gather yourself and be sit under one small boy. What is he telling you? Washing, pray, washing all of you. For to them that are without understanding, to the gather, even spiritual things are misunderstood. They are not meant to understand the mystery of spiritual things. So God said to Abraham, I will make of thee. How many of you still want God to make of you? The hands are reduced. Now I'm saying this to say to you that, you see, in your journey to greatness, when you don't see the things you are expecting, still know that what you see is part of God making of me. Delay is part of God making of me. Disappointment is part of God making of me. Lack is part of God making of me. Romans 8:28. He said, all things we know. I'm convinced it is settled that this thing I'm going through is a process, not ordinary. Have you not read the Bible saying that this little affliction of this world cannot be compared to the joy that is yet, come on now, it is not revealed yet to be revealed, not to everybody, to them that trust him. Greatness amidst of uncertainties. I don't know. And that was why God was said to a man, 75 years of age, married with a wife, trying to have children. They couldn't have children settled. Is this when they become wanderers? He said, come with your wife. I will make of thee, and I will show you where we will meet. He said, leave your relatives, your father, everybody. You see, most times our problem is the way we carry our relatives. Please, I'm not trying to say you shouldn't put things to your relatives, but you don't carry them beyond where God wants you to carry them. Don't carry them to the extent they became the reason why you don't serve God genuinely. Let it not become your excuses. certain things. Time and life has taught me that they will survive with capital S if you die. I can go to where somebody died. Everywhere I cry, mostly that grave time. After the grave time, once the rice is ready, you go see people, they jump over rice and drink. And you ask yourself, this one upper, only on the vampire. Then you realize that life, it is nothing. You are only valuable by your life. If you are gone, listen to me, they will live like you have never existed.
Yes, sir.
Hosanna, he have been
Jesse Penny. one of the best shops, malls in America. Was a tighter. She was, you know, giving. And Jesse Penny is known all over America. If you never buy anything from Jesse Penny, it is called the dog shop. And Jesse Penny is a native, began to experiment something. He stopped tighter. Jesse Penny is so nosedived that when I was young, she realized herself and said, wait a minute! The relationship with God is only where greatness is guaranteed. Do you know caterpillar? Google it. The original family now operates that owns that label caterpillar are Christians. They enter into covenant by tithing 40% of every income. And then there is no place on earth that will be a road walk without caterpillar. Greatness is a price, it's not a wish. It only takes men of a good understanding who are reckless with their life. Read the other one. Read my lips. Who are what? Reckless with their life when it comes to the kingdom matter. Those who can say, if I perish, I perish. Listen, if your life is valuable to you and you want to preserve your life, you're not in any way going to see greatness, because greatness will take a lot from you. Greatness is not cheap. He said, I will make you great, but I will isolate you. I will isolate you that nobody will help you until you begin to know that I'm your exceeding help. I'm your only help. And you have no plan B unless God help me. I am finished. That's why some of us, when we start like this, we know that it's not the help of man. Every help of man or God was that God brought through man. And we thank God for the men that God have used. And listen to me, it is only because you are connected to God. Otherwise, if men give you their own help, you can't pay. You will serve as a slave all the days of your life. But when God compels men to help you, they will help you and forget you.
Yes, sir.
And they will know you see and say, thank you that you collected it all. Thank you. Do you know how God does that? Let me help you. I've said it the other day. God will give you solution to their problem. Huh? God may give them a simple portion. Not portion, but whatever. They believe. And if they don't give you anointing, trust me, power. Within this happen. They begin to feel they owe you. They begin to feel so indebted. And they come to you and say, please, sir, please take this 20 million. Please, and we'll be paying you salary of 1 million every month for the next 2 weeks. Please don't use this for small money. I think it's a big money. It does happen. There are people that has this thing and God wants to use, flow it, and the transfer of wealth. That's how God will do it. That's why, listen, if you need to be anointed, be anointed. If you need to do anything, do it well. If you need to learn carpenter, learn it well. If it's mechanic, learn it well. Because it's through that thing you do. The big man there will just spoil. And they call him. He said, okay, you take the maintenance of this every month, whether you spoil or not, you have 100,000. They call it maintenance contract. If they deploy for common computer, now what do we? There was one model. And I was telling you, small model. A man paid cash in Canada, $19 million, one small motto. Cash. Small car. You don't think I'm going to have to be. How much is there? People are buying it. So when I tell you somebody will dash you $10 million, you think it's too much. And they don't dash you because they like your face. Nobody gives you such money. There must be something you have to offer. To receive such favor from men, and I prophesy to you, from today, you will not be normal on Nabi. And are you ready for God to pour you out? Do you know there are kind of environment you live in? The noise of that environment will not allow the best to come out of you. There are kind of friends you keep because of the kind of things they feed your ears with. They will not allow you to think and think of something right. God said, I will bring you out from among them. So he brought Abraham out from his kindred, his country, his relatives, and separated him. But the way, he has no option. Had God brought you in the place, you have no option than just to come to this altar. Say, Lord, if you don't do it, the women now. Have you seen that men that are so despised are always men that are later great men? Because they come to a point of no return. If we perish, let's perish. Maybe because you have an auntie who will always give you a handout, and you're living in a handout. You're living in a handout, and you're buying shoes with a handout. You're living small life, and you want to be great. Until you say no. The Bible says, until the prodigal son come to his senses and realize that in his father's house, there are people who are living as second-class citizens, but they are living better than him. The Bible says he came to his own senses. Your greatness begins the day you come to your senses. I return. And begin to trust God absolutely. And this is why you come to church, they beg you to sit down. They beg you to stand, they beg you to do things. And you want greatness. And that's why I'm teaching you. If I want to preach to you, to shout and get excited, you go home with nothing. I'm calling you to responsibility. I'm calling you to responsibility. If you want greatness, stop envying them that are great. You don't know their price. When they pass, they are going to say, don't go. $20. What do you call them now?
Yahoo.
Everybody knows Yahoo. Listen, when you have such small mindedness, you will never taste it. Anything you don't appreciate, you will never taste it. If you don't appreciate greatness, you will never have it. When you see men by the grace of God, God has lifted, thank God for that grace in their life and celebrate that grace. Because when you don't celebrate, you will not connect with you. Pastor, actually, I went to Dove Faith. I've taken to Dove Faith before. I went to Dove Faith. You see that? The first day we went to Dove Faith, as I step in there, in my mind, I said, I want to see this man. Yes. I said, I want to see this man. We left. The next day I went, I said, I want to see Abraham. The man came. They said, this is Abraham. Short, dark, unassuming. It's only this purpose way for long. People don't say that guy. What? If wealth and greatness is shared by size, me, I forget better size before the man. But if you enter that place, and as I saw him, I said, sir, thank you for being a great man. I said, one day I will go do something like this. Check your number, maybe I can get out. I said, one day I will produce something like this. Is it the landscape? Is it planning? If you call them about their school, they don't talk to you. They say, come to the school. Because if you say, come to the school with your child. Because if you ever get to that school with your child, unless you don't have money, that's the only reason why you will not go. They don't tell you anything about the school. They say, come. I said, when you're coming, come with a person. So you carry your child. When you get there, your child tells you, daddy, this is where I'm going. Because before you get into the classroom, the greatness of the environment will attract you. Greatness has a perfume.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Even the poor perceive it.
Yes, sir.
Let me to close so that we go. I can't scratch this one. Maybe I'll put it on Monday on Friday. If you want to hear the detailed balance of this message, let's see you on Friday. Okay, Monday, Wednesday, I'll check Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Like this, you may think we're wasting your time by calling you to have more services of prayer. No, there's something we want to inject inside of you. Complete setting things out of your life. So God, in a nutshell, I want to come down. Now, God said to Abraham, if I must make great out of you, you must trust me. So one other thing, we know we're talking about favor. Huh? Favor with God and favor with man. Now we are talking about trusting God. We'll talk about faith also. We'll talk about faith. But now trusting God. If I come and trust him, see as I realize, say any hiding from this one. I'm trusting that he will not let me fall. No matter how bad. So I just carry myself. God is saying, without even counting, trust me when you can't even trace me. Child of God, it can be confusing. I want to admit to you, it can be confusing. The only thing that summarizes this is trust the Lord. Trust him when all you have done, all you thought you should have done. You have served the Lord. If they put yourself on your scale, you say, he said, I've done well. I don't try. And now you are expecting God to give you your report card and to pat your back and say, you don't try. Take this blessing. And he said, No. He won't tell you anything and keep you quiet. No affirmation, not all. And rather he said, my grace is sufficient for you. He said, how long? I am 45 years. You're saying grace is sufficient. Are you not seeing this mockery? You say your grace is sufficient. Are you seeing this way? Everybody that is married make me look as if I'm not. My not being married is a curse. They've not seen that after church. Even though that should have helped me to enter their bottom, will soon leave empty. You're telling me. Emmanuel was very small. And after service, when he was falling, the brother who used to talk, I said, hey brother, 5'4", don't say that with that one. Don't doubt him, he's not with that one. That's all I want. 5'4", as I hit that. I said, bro, okay, this man for pity, if not, this your baby. I said, then what, I have a baby, they can make you open the door. And as he said it, it wasn't easy in my mind, because it's my mate. I went to him and said, Lord, go let me. Lord, go let me. You see, I do it in the secret. I come and tell. See, don't let people see this thing. I'm not trying to tell you there's no broken time. In the secret place, make it, pray it. But when you come and show a smile, say, Lord, where? All of a sudden, I didn't know what was preparing me. When I hit my mom, when the guys see my move, I back up and say, boy, how far? In the way forward. I say, enter. Let me put this. But after 4-4 had no AC, let me put this. He had forgotten, but I remembered. People will say things that you will not forget, and it will make you to walk. Amen. He had forgotten. Whether that joke or not joke, or me, not be joke. Sometimes people joke, they joke, and they go to bone. How many of you, somebody joke, but they joke, not be joke. They joke, this one, not be joke. See me with my baby and my wife. As we are marching, coming, and rain is coming. I saw you empty coming as a cross. I said, cross, I better just help us. He said, no, please, your baby, I'm not carrying this way for me to you. You're kind too much. For envy with my emptiness. But then I suspend all my waist, no plenty. They never see anything. Do you know that I'm made to see your greatness even when you don't wear the greatness? And they fight you. We'll continue. will have church all the week so that I can finish the teaching that is in my head. There is a lot the Lord keep depositing in night after night. That's why I tell them, don't let me go. I go to the pastor sister. We hardly speak of home. We there America, no, we know they talk. Ask her, I come back 12. 12 in the night, I preach 3 services on a Sunday. Preach one in Port Harcourt, come out to where I go to another place, come back. I preach 11 p.m. on a Sunday, people still want to hear. The other day I told them, I was close by 9. They said, 3 room. I told them, I said, the place, they said, for where? Bishop, this is your last day.
So I decree.